Hey, don't skip ahead! Before I explain how to install the launcher and get Repentogon running for Repentance Plus, there's some very important information I need to explain first. Repentogon for Repentance Plus is finally here. If you don't know, Repentogon is a script extender for the Binding of Isaac that extends the game's modding capabilities with much-needed bug fixes, extra functionality, and performance enhancements. This is just like script extenders for other games, such as Skyrim. Something very important to note is that Repentogon runs on an older version of Repentance Plus. This means that when launching the game with Repentogon enabled, you'll be put on version 1.9.7.12.J273 Repentance Plus, instead of whatever the current latest version is, so certain features such as internal item descriptions will be missing. The launcher can be run using the latest version of Repentance Plus from Steam, and will handle downpatching your game automatically, so there's no need to worry about that. The reason why Repentogon is in an older version of Repentance Plus is that Repentogon works very differently from a typical mod, and any small change to the game's code can completely alter or break something with how Repentogon functions. Updating Repentogon to newer versions of the game takes a significant amount of time and testing, and because of how Repentance Plus was being updated very frequently and has more updates planned in the future, updating Repentogon to the latest version became an endless task. Staying on a particular version allows Repentogon to keep working stably, even if more updates for Isaac come out. On that topic, you may be wondering why there's even a new launcher for Repentogon in the first place, when Repentogon for Base Repentance never had one. The reason is that the launcher handles downpatching the latest Steam version of the game for you, simplifying the process greatly. Also, the old version of installing Repentogon didn't work on some users' machines, so this new install method makes running Repentogon easier and more consistent for everybody. Alright, with that out of the way, it's time to get into installation instructions. I'll start with installing on Windows, then Linux and Steam Deck. Then, I'll talk about migrating your save data to Repentance Plus with Repentogon. Afterwards, I'll talk about some extra features the launcher has, then finally I'll talk about common issues with the launcher and how to fix them. If you need extra help, you can join the Modding of Isaac Discord server and talk with Repentogon developers directly in the Repentogon text channel. First, I'll discuss how to install the launcher on Windows, and then Linux and Steam Deck. To install the launcher on Windows, you can download it as a .zip file at the link in the description and the pinned comment, or by going to the website on screen. To extract the launcher's files, right-click the .zip file and click Extract, or use a program like WinRAR or 7-Zip. You may extract the launcher's files wherever you like, except where the game itself is located. Additionally, if you extract the launcher in a folder named Repentogon, do not put this folder next to where the game itself is located. In general, it's much easier to put the launcher in a folder somewhere on your desktop or in your documents. Alternatively, you may receive an automatic download of the launcher if you still have the old version of Repentogon for Base Repentance. If you need to find the launcher's files, you can find them in the folder where Isaac is located by going to Steam and navigating to the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Click on the gear on the right side of the screen, hover over Manage, and then click Browse Local Files. Next, we need to actually run the launcher. Run REPENTOGONLauncher.exe, or use the Repentogon shortcut that was created if you installed it automatically. When running the launcher for the first time, a window for the initial setup should open, asking for the location of the game's executable. This location may be automatically detected. If not, click Select Executable and locate the isaac-ng.exe file in the game's folder. Once again, you can access this folder easily by going to Steam and navigating to the Binding of Isaac Rebirth, then clicking on the gear on the right side of the screen, hovering over Manage, and then clicking Browse Local Files. If the launcher says that your version of Isaac is not compatible with Repentogon, note that you must either have the latest official Steam version of Repentance Plus, or version 1.9.7.12.J273. Further help with installation can be found at the end of the video in the troubleshooting chapter. Lastly, it's recommended to make it so that launching the game through Steam runs the Repentogon launcher instead. This is required for Steam Remote Play to function properly with Repentogon and makes things a whole lot more convenient. To do this, navigate to the Binding of Isaac Rebirth on Steam. Click on the gear on the right side of the screen, then select Properties. This will open a new window. Then, under the General tab, locate the Launch Options field. We'll need to enter a small command here. First, we'll paste the full path to where the Repentogon launcher is located. You can easily get this by navigating to where repentogonlauncher.exe is located, right-clicking it, and clicking Copy as Path. Make sure that the file path is between two quotation marks like so. Then make a space and type dash dash Isaac equals percentage command percentage. Make sure this is all done as one word and all in lowercase. After this is done, simply close this window. Steam will now automatically run the launcher when you click play. Now let's talk about installing on Linux and Steam Deck. If you're a Windows user, skip ahead to the Save Migration chapter at the timestamp on screen. Installing on Linux requires a few extra steps. Firstly, navigate to the Binding of Isaac Rebirth on Steam. Click on the gear on the right side of the screen, then select Properties. This will open a new window. Click the Installed Files tab on the left, then click Browse. Don't close the Steam menu after this because we'll need to go back to it later. Within the game's directory, create a new folder here named REPENTOGON Launcher. It is very important that it follows the exact same capitalization as what's on screen. If this folder already exists, then it's possible that you already received the automatic download of the launcher from the old version of REPENTOGON on Base Repentance. If so, skip the next step. Download the REPENTOGON Launcher as a .zip file at the link in the description and the pinned comment, or by going to the website on screen, then extract it into this newly created REPENTOGON Launcher folder. Return to the prior Steam menu and click the General tab. In the Launch Options box, paste the following command found in the description, pinned comment, and on screen. Pause the video if you need to. Now, when launching the game through Steam, the launcher will be run instead. Running the launcher automatically checks for updates for both REPENTOGON and the launcher. When running the launcher for the first time, a window for the initial setup should open, asking for the location of the game's executable. This location may be automatically detected. If not, click Select Executable and locate the isaac-ng.exe file in the game's folder. Once again, you can access this folder easily by going to Steam and navigating to the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Click on the gear on the right side of the screen, hover over Manage, and then click Browse Local Files. If the launcher says that your version of Isaac is not compatible with REPENTOGON, note that you must either have the latest official Steam version of Repentance Plus or version 1.9.7.12.J273. Further help can be found at the end of the video in the troubleshooting chapter. Let's talk about migrating your save data from Base Repentance to Repentance Plus. Keep in mind that this may only be necessary if you are newly migrating to Repentance Plus. Repentance Plus uses a separate save file from Base Repentance, even without REPENTOGON. However, the game only imports your save data from Base Repentance once when first launching the game with Repentance Plus. That means if you had launched Repentance Plus at any time in the past, then returned to Base Repentance, your Repentance Plus save data is likely still stuck at the point when you previously launched it. REPENTOGON allows you to easily and freely import your missing achievements and unlocks from Base Repentance, as well as export any newly gained achievements and unlocks back to Base Repentance. While on the title screen in REPENTOGON for Repentance Plus, press the tilde key to open the REPENTOGON console. This is the same key you use to open the debug console in Vanilla Isaac. At the top left corner of the screen, select Tools, then click Game Options. This will open a new menu. Navigate to the Save Management tab, then click Import from Repentance to import all of your missing achievements and unlocks from your Base Repentance save file. If the button is disabled, make sure you're on the title screen where the Changelogs paper is located. Keep in mind that this process will never remove achievements or progress, and only unlocks things that are obtained in one version but missing in another. Next, I'll give a brief introduction to the features that the REPENTOGON Launcher has, as well as a few extra configuration options. I won't go over the more advanced features, instead just talking about what's broadly relevant. First, let's talk about the various settings. Under the Launcher configuration, you can enable Stealth Mode. Enabling this option will make it so that when you run the launcher, the window will be skipped and Isaac will be immediately launched. Under Launch Options is a single setting named Launch Mode. This allows you to easily switch between launching REPENTOGON and launching the latest version of REPENTOGON Plus without REPENTOGON. Under REPENTOGON Options, there is an Advanced Options button which opens a new window. In this window, you can reinstall and repair REPENTOGON if something didn't install correctly. You can also forcefully check for updates for the launcher, although this isn't usually necessary as the launcher automatically checks for updates when run. Under Modding Options, there are two buttons that I want to talk about. Firstly is Check Game Logs, which allows you to open and locate the files that the game keeps a log of things in. This is very useful for sharing bug reports with mod developers, who often need the made log file to fix glitches and crashes. There's also a simple mod manager here. This is pretty straightforward and lets you easily manage your mods without having to open the game. I'm going to end this video with a list of common issues that may appear when running the launcher. If you need extra help, you can join the Modding of Isaac Discord server and get help directly in the REPENTOGON text channel. If the REPENTOGON installation is broken or invalid, make sure you follow the installation instructions exactly, especially if you're using Linux or Steam Deck. If you're sure you've done that, try restarting the launcher so that it can automatically check for updates and allow the launcher to update if it needs to. If that hasn't fixed anything, try clicking Choose EXE in the main launcher window to repeat repeat the initial setup process. Make sure that the correct Binding of Isaac Repentance Plus executable is selected. If all else fails, click the Advanced Options button under Game Configuration in the main launcher window, then click Reinstall/Repair Repentogon. If your issue still persists, or the issue occurs repeatedly, please join the Discord server mentioned earlier. Lastly, if you're missing your unlocks, achievements, or save data from base repentance, use the Chapters feature on YouTube and rewind to the Save Migration section of the video. If you're having problems with the launcher, encountering bugs, or just want to make a suggestion, consider creating an issue on the Repentogon or Repentogon Launcher GitHub pages on screen, also linked in the description and pinned comment. Once again, if you need direct help from someone, consider joining the Modding of Isaac Discord server and asking in the Repentogon text channel. That's all, and have fun modding!